The Pap Attack.
In the 1980s, Bayer Corporation produced a medicine that was supposed to improve the lives of hemophiliacs. Bayer didn't tell those hemophiliacs that their product was infected with HIV. Entire families of hemophiliacs died with AIDS as the virus spread within households. When Bayer was ordered to stop selling their drug in America, they dumped their AIDS-laden product in Asia, and they killed Asian families by the thousands. No one with Bayer management was arrested. No one who made those psychopathic quality decisions went to prison. They claimed the protection of their status as a corporation, as they put it. That corporate status gave management the ability to kill people for profit and not go to prison. I handled the civil case against Bayer, and I saw firsthand that this was a rogue operation, not typical of most American corporations. But how do you put that rogue corporation in prison? Who do you arrest? Today, rogue corporations have the best of all worlds. They take advantage of the constitutional protections that were originally written for living, breathing humans. They argue that the U.S. Supreme Court mandated 130 years ago that we have to treat a corporation exactly like we would treat a real person. They argue that the 14th Amendment was written to protect their corporate person status with equal protection and due process. But when the conduct of that corporate person is so vile and ugly that they make decisions to kill people to increase their profit, well, we hear the argument that it was a corporate-wide decision. We hear that there was no single person that we can hold accountable. They tell us that many people were involved in the acts, and we can't throw the entire corporation in prison. The U.S. Supreme Court's now considering expanding the definition of person even farther for America's corporation. This is a Supreme Court that's packed mostly with lawyers who were employed by America's most powerful corporations before they became judges. It's a court full of judges who sit on that court largely because the corporate powerhouses that they once represented put them on that court. The decision they're going to make is predictable. When this court finishes writing its opinion about treating corporations more like people, the product they deliver is going to look like one of those warm and fuzzy Hallmark greeting cards that rallies our emotions with feel-good pictures of puppies and kittens and cherub-like babies. By way of words, they're going to paint a Norman Rockwell-like picture that's going to make us want to invite this saint-like corporate person to dinner with our families. Well, a word of advice. If you do invite them over for dinner, send the children to another room and count the silver settings before that corporate person leaves the house. But most importantly, recognize that the Mother Teresa character the U.S. Supreme Court tries to sell you has more in common with Freddy Krueger. As this court expands the constitutional protections of this poor, misunderstood entity known as a corporate person, they should also spend some time expanding avenues that allow us to do what we do with any psychopath who harms our family. Put handcuffs on them and throw them in prison.
The Pap Attack on Air America Radio Network.